The launch for the annual Bob Marley One Love football matches took place early on Friday at Tuff Gong International in Kingston, Jamaica. The event, which is in its 41st year, will be held on February 22nd at the Anthony Spaulding Sports Complex in Arnett Gardens. CEO of the Professional Football Jamaica Limited, PFJL, Owen Hill, commenced the launch by highlighting the significance of the event.
We know the power of sport. We understand the importance of having these events. So we are in full support of that. And I'm sure that come February 22nd, because this is a stable event, you will consistently see the known faces and a few more that may come on. I'm understanding that we may have a few surprises in the bag that will be on show, but more specifically, it's really the initiative. Why is it being executed?
The event's organizer and conceptualizer, Clive Busy Campbell, spoke passionately about the importance of using sport as a medium for youth development.
This year, as we celebrate the Bob Marley One Love football matches for 41 years, I pray for peace and guidance from the Almighty. As Bob Marley said, no care for you, no care for me, let's change that. Let us care for each other, and in so doing, let us take care of ourselves.
Clive also called for an urgent intervention in addressing the growing violence among the youth in Jamaica.
Here, as we celebrate the Bob Marley One Love football matches for 41 years, I pray for peace and guidance from the Almighty. As Bob Marley said, no care for you, no care for me, let's change that. Let us care for each other, and in so doing, let us take care of ourselves.
The proceeds from the event will be used to purchase equipment for various elementary schools that Clive says he has been in contact with in recent months. So team, our team, Sportsmax, of course, you know, proud to be affiliated with such a competition, and all proceeds will be going for something good.
Yeah, a powerful message coming from Clive Busy Campbell, the organizer, conceptualizer of the event. So powerful that we had to play twice. But really fabulous message. And it's good to see that we can still have these events where we give back, where institutions that need it can benefit. And that's what we have here with the Bob Marley One Love football matches. I hear that Lance Whitaker should be turning out. And the only reason that he might not is because he has a slight hamstring discomfort.
My hamstring is fine at the moment, so we'll see what happens. I'm not sure if Owen Hill was referencing my potential appearance when he said there could be some surprises in the bag.
Yeah, for real.
Actually, no. I spoke with Busy Campbell some months ago, and he was actually trying to find out from the Brazilian embassy if he could assist in getting one of the big Brazilian names of the past to be a part of the day. I'm not sure where that went, but I know Busy's a pretty influential guy, so let's see how that goes. Yeah. I can't believe, though, that this is 41 years now.
Yeah.
You know, time really, really flies. I remember when it started, but to think that it's 41 years now, it's significant that it's been around so long.
And apparently they're still working on getting the Brazilian to play, and they're optimistic that it could still happen.
Yeah, well,
I'm looking forward to that. Then I'm definitely going.
So you wouldn't go for me or Lance?
You're playing?
Well, I have participated in that event twice, right?
But
I competed in the sprinting section.
Okay.
On that day, Usain Bolt competed in the football. Actually scored a fabulous header at the National Stadium. But I won the 100 meters 1 year.
Yes.
And
I wonder what the field was like.
Yeah, well, now I'm wondering if there were people
Because if Usain Bolt opted to compete in the football part of the program.
And then you won.
And scored. It does suggest that the sprinting field was a little bit lame. if Ricardo would have been able to win.
I don't remember who was in the field, but then I was so far ahead, I was really focused on me.
So you didn't speak to your teammates before?
Teammates.
Well, in competition.
I was focused. I was zoned into competition. And apparently I was told I had all the track and field moves down. But I went to defend my title the next year and I came fourth. But I had injury issues.
So do we expect to see you this time?
No, I'm focusing on my tennis.
And I don't think there's a track and field component this time.
Yeah. Okay. I don't think there has been one
for a while. Yeah.
All right, team. Well, what's for sure is, of course, it's sport with a good cause, and we're looking forward to bringing you the best of that. Let's take a break. Stay with SportsMax on YouTube and follow us on all social pages for updates, news, and entertainment.